Agonizing to me to see a guy make a mistake in this phase of the game because you can. It's all on him. All eyes there. He's got a chance to make the punt return, and instead, he ends up putting it on the carpet.
Puts it on the carpet. The little pellet shootout. Never been suited for a returner on this field turn surface.
No, not at all. And a bunch of them go up when they're all trying to get to the football.
It was Alton Robinson that time on the tackle.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. To throw is Prescott. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Niners have taken
it. Who was that, Romy?
Nick Folk for the point after. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score, Niners 7, Seahawks nothing.
No, I got TV on, huh?
Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
We're not that.
This will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. 25-yard line. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now. First and 10 at their 25-yard line. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 14 in the Seahawks first. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down.
He'd given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw again, Wilson. That's to the tight end, Colby Parkinson. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
A 2-yard pickup makes it.
They go play action with Wilson. They'll roll him out right. He may try and run for this. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. Second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
1-yard gain brings up second and 9.
Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Flush to his right. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson. forced out to his left. Fourth down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And Myers able to knock it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. These kickers now, it's like you take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their history. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along. But their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Throwing again on second down, Prescott, and it's incomplete.
Prescott's pass, thrown to the sideline, and incomplete.
They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
On the sneak, it's Prescott. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Prescott to throw this time. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A good pick up there, 26 yards. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34.
Nice job there, utilizing his big target and overthinking. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Here's a four receiver look now. Three of those guys out to the right side on second and 8. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 16. 15 yards on the play, first down. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. A great effort there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. Extra point up and good by Folk. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Fair catch signal for and taken successfully.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal, the way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. On second down, Elliott. They find some open field here. And that one just went upfield across the 45. The play began back at the 23, and they pick up 23. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. Now they try the right side here. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play. That'll be second down.
Second and 10.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. He gets it in the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Gain of 2. Brings up third.
On third down, they're going to go with the option. And this won't be enough. A good secure tackle, and they stop him a few yards shy of the 46.
26-yard line. A gain of 5.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. It was too far for a field goal try. You don't really gain a whole lot out of a punt, so I don't think you have much of a problem with that, do you?
No, not at all. I think it's the right play, the exact right play, because even if you want to play defense and pin them deep, you know how hard it is for a punter to knock one dead inside the 10-yard line. That's not necessarily easily done. So I think going for it there is the right call.
Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
First down, 49ers.
From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That catch goes for only a couple.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Now a handoff looking away. And he only manages a couple here now. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Prescott on the gun on third. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds. And now fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 1 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in the second quarter. Here comes the 49ers punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense, they went for it, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. It's just wanted to not get the first down. To have the defense out there.
But he trusted his defense.
He trusted his defense very much. And I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive. Because I'll get the wild bunch back in the up.
Let's see what his offense can do. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Steps away to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The lines move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion and a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those Nicholson packages, don't they?
A quick target here, complete to Metcalf. Wilson and Metcalf at time, first down, Seattle. Off the play fake, here's Wilson. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off on the first rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Take over first.
Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Seahawks, 43-yard line.
Throwing, Prescott. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. We'll have stats and scores around the NFL as we reach now, arguably, the halfway point of the season. Oh, now he's strapped. He lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one way incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Throwing again, Wilson. Throwing the out route, incomplete. That's Elliott. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down with a nice little game. Third and two, now Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. Open man is Metcalf, he's got it. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off on a safety, Jack Whiskey Tart. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives without throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Following the interception, here's Prescott. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly. Got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
A second down throw for Prescott. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. They showed off a nice juke in the defender before the next wave could bring him down. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left there with third and one. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Prescott on first down. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
I know you thought seeing a touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a short 6 points for the contact, jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on for the end of the play. Again, looking for Samuel, this time to catch May. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. On first and 10, Prescott. Now they set up the screen. It's complete. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They moved it a combined 33 yards.
First down, 49ers.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. That'll bring up second down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
throwing again. Prescott on second and 10. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. Debo Samuel was the intended receiver, and it's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. And again, it's Prescott. Flushed out right. This is caught. And the 49ers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how the offense, what they decide to do in play calling. Going to continue to throw the ball. Going to probably lean more on the running game. It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a snap with the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they run the heat, and if he pushes out, they're fine with that, and it goes to the completion.
Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. He'll find Metcalf. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. Dylan Elliott tries to run it in. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Now a handoff here to his running back. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground. But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. 3 touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often throwing wide receivers, maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They start on the ground without him. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
Now Wilson. That's into the hands of Parkinson, the tight end.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
He's got to let the man. It's Gronkowski. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Wilson swings this out to Metcalf. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
DK Metcalf. 4 yards on the pickup. They'll run with Elliott.
And he's going to have this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Niners' 40-yard line. Calling a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time right. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A good pickup there, 21 yards. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up second and 12. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Off the edge, the sack by Matt Ioannidis. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
They go play action with Wilson. Looking for the end zone. And it will be caught, but out of the end zone since the field judge is ruled incomplete. Fourth down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage. And Myers winds up yanking it. This is no good. Wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses, it's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
At the 42-yard line.
And that is incomplete. Force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. They tried to throw on second down. Unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. From the shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he is going to have a 49ers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on third and one. Give him 3 yards there on the first down pickup.
First down.
It's going to be caught by Samuel. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
First down, 49ers.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
A gain of 4 yards. First down, San Francisco.
Prescott from the gun. And he's got it. And across the chart, into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Dak Prescott now 4 touchdown passes on the afternoon. And the 49ers add on to their lead. Full connects on the extra point. And that will make this a 19-point game. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. taken at about the one. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there. And trailing big here in this fourth quarter. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And he will bring this one back. Touchdown. Now Fulk for the extra point. PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From what we see, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as it kicks away following that fumble return.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Throw in the middle, taken in, and he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 13, it's a first down. They'll look to throw here. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. Chewing up big yardage, another nice game there. This one goes for 20.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go and mark it in the win column, but as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
At the 18-yard line.
On second and 12, Prescott will fire this deep to Ayuk. And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line.
A gain of 52 yards. And the 49er first down.
They'll give it here to his running back. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 31-yard line.
On second and 11 now, Prescott. This will be caught inside the 10. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line.
At the 8-yard line.
23 yards on the play. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
To try again after the sack. Prescott. And it's caught. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. They give him a dozen on the pitch and catch, but now they're up against a third and goal. That's going to keep it. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. He loses four, and it brings up four.
Just a simple run play there on third and one, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped him, bringing up fourth down.
And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And that will push the lead up from 26, and it grows up to 29.